Hello and welcome to Standout on Radio Kerry.
Ian O'Connell is 21 and a presenter with Radio Kerry. His life was changed forever when 5 years ago he went cycling with friends in Killarney National Park.
There was a log on the kind of path and it was overgrown with grass and my front wheel just hit it and I went flying over the handlebars and I knew straight away something was wrong when I fell. I heard a crack in my neck and body just went lifeless.
I remember I got a phone call from his friend Michael to come out to Muckross that Ian was after falling off his bike. And he said this, he's down the ground and he can't move. So we went straight out. He was down the ground, couldn't move, nothing.
He was conscious, that was the only thing that he was able to talk to us and everything, which was good like.
I was carried to Tralee General. I spent 10 nights there, which basically just seemed like endless MRIs, X-ray scans, and I was on my back the whole time with sandbags on either side of my head.
Ian was stabilised and then transferred to the Mater in Dublin, where he remained for 4 months. He then spent 5 months in rehab in Dunleary, where he heard the devastating news that he would not walk again as he was paralysed from the shoulders down.
When the occupational therapist and physio came up and they said, right Ian, we're going to fit you for a wheelchair. And I just kind of looked at them. I said, a wheelchair? I had myself convinced that I'd be up in 2 weeks running around playing football again. Then all the questions started going, why do I need it? How long will I be in it for? And, you know, they were just being straight up honest. And I said, look, Ian, you can either cry in a corner, but crying isn't going to make me walk again. So I said I'd use it my story to help other people.
My next guest is here tonight, and he is here tonight to tell a pretty incredible story. But also
nearly a year after the accident, when Ian appeared on The Late Late Show, he revealed his mindset for the future.
I always say to myself, if I can't stand up, I'll stand out.
And it's a philosophy by which he has lived his life ever since.
I was always positive before my accident, but like seeing people in wheelchairs before my accident, I just thought their legs don't work, but like there's so much more behind the scenes. And I think that everybody has the same drive as myself. You just kind of have to dig deep enough to find it. And I suppose I didn't know how strong I was until my only option was to be strong. And I think you find out a lot about yourself when you go that low and when something that bad happens to you.
He is a very positive outlook, like, so he has. He can't see any negativity in anything, like everything. He'll always see the bright side of everything. I don't know which
is
the me.
Where did you get that from?
Came from the cock side.
But life was to deliver even more challenges. In 2019, Ian took a bad turn when a clot formed in his lung, causing a cardiac arrest.
It's called paramedics and the Killarney first responders came and CPR and the defibrillator and everything. And I spent, I think it was about 9 days in ICU in Tralee. But thank God I'm back healthy again and fighting. I'm like a cat with 9 lives.
Growing up in Killarney, Ian had always been very positive and very involved in local clubs.
Well, I suppose he was into sport in a big way. He played football and hurling and rugby for a while. A bit of a rogue, really.
Recently, he was invited to speak on the topic of mental health for people with disabilities at the Beyond Limits conference at the University of Limerick.
It was great to meet people there, you know, in wheelchairs, in similar situations as myself. So it was good, and I do a lot of public speaking in schools and kind of events and all that.
You have a busy life.
I do.
In 2018, Ian became a beneficiary of the All-Ireland GAA Golf Challenge event, which raises funds for deserving causes.
Some years ago, I was invited down to a hurling seminar here in Killarney, and they were trying to promote the game of hurling, I suppose, locally. And there was a few young chaps there that time, Ian being one of them. And they were started poking around, and I was with them, and I was highly impressed by his skill, you know, at the game. And he looked a very promising hurler at the time. Very shortly after that, I heard of his very sad accident, which caused him to be immobilised and not being able to play sport. But the All-Ireland Golf Challenge stepped in at that stage and arranged to get a vehicle for him to give him independence and able to move around, and I think that was upgraded again for him in the last couple of days.
It's an unbelievable addition, like, for to travel, especially long distances and stuff, and it ramp drive into it from the back, and you're able to stay inside in my own chair and everything, so it's ideal.
Advances in technology play a major role in Ian's life.
It's been unreal. They gave me a mouth stick, and it's basically just a mouth stick with a kind of a stylus at the end, and I can tap my phone and my computer and stuff. It basically mimics a finger, and that thing was the best thing I got since my accident. When I got it and took my first selfie after my accident, it was one of the best things I got since it gave me the independence to talk to my friends again.
And his high-tech chair is a huge boost to his self-sufficiency.
It gave me sort of way more independence again. Like, I was depending on people to push me there for a few months until I got fitted for this chair.
Ian is also an Instagram star. First prompted by his appearance on The Late Late Show, he now has almost 55,000 followers.
Straight after my accident, I started kind of documenting my rehab every day, and when I was in rehab in Dunleary and in hospital and stuff, and then I just kept kind of showing what my day-to-day life and everything, and then Conor McGregor put up a picture of the two of us. That blew it up 20,000 more.
His radio career has also taken off. A few weeks ago, Ian was nominated on a shortlist of 5 for Best Newcomer at the IMRO Awards.
I didn't pull it off on the night, but there's always, like Liverpool fans say, there's always next year.
Michael and Nora are hopeful that because their only child is just 21, future discoveries in medical science will enhance his life further. But what does Ian see in his future?
I want to get my story out there, maybe travel the world doing talks, get married and hopefully have kids and stuff. And I suppose just to help people in general with my own accident, showing them that, you know, I suppose to appreciate what they have and just to be happy.
Would you say, are you happy?
Couldn't be happier. And I know it might sound weird, but I'm just as happy now as any time. I've great people around me, you know. I've done more since my accident in a wheelchair than I would have done in my whole lifetime beforehand. Like, I don't know where I would be now, but like, I've met people that I'd only have dreamed of meeting, gone places that I'd only have dreamed of going. Very happy, extremely happy, yeah. So that's all for this week's Stand Out on Radio Kerry. Join me again next Wednesday night at 8 p.m. Enjoy the rest of your week. Life is life.